Item 001. Code name, The Conspiracy. Object class, Explained. Site responsible, Site 01. Director, Overseas. Research head, Overseas. Assigned task force, Red right hand. Level 6. Special chronology procedures. Incident 001 Greek letter Gamma's definitive, canonical timeline is recorded on solid-state databases. Two copies exist, one is located within a secured headquarters and the location of the other is known to the overseers. Red right hand has successfully seized all documentation of Incident 001 Greek letter Gamma which are not currently available to any public. Current theory is that as a result of SCP-001's effect, there exists no possibility for any trespassing within SCP-001's continuity via distortion of time and or dimensional space. Quality of life health insurance plans and any extraordinary medical expenses one are to be provided to the witnesses of Incident 001 Greek letter Gamma. Massive publicizing and public reaffirmation of established perspectives on Incident 001 Greek letter Gamma are to be disseminated through both reputable and alternative news sources in order to blunt the spread of uncontrolled manufactured information. Marketing and production front companies are to fund independent media outlets creating, distributing, and selling advertising space on media catering to narrow niches of alternative perspectives which are rooted to or branched off of an Incident 001 Greek letter Gamma perspective variant. Description. SCP-001 is the projectile which killed U.S. President John F. Kennedy, fired by an unidentifiable number of assailants acting simultaneously as part of one or more conspiracies. Upon impact, human perception began falling out of sync with objective reality at an individual level. The events surrounding SCP-001's trajectory are designated as Incident 001 Greek letter Gamma. Although the divergent standards of objectivity are largely compatible enough to allow for human society to function, that does not mean they are not a threat to the long-term viability of human civilization and intelligent life as a whole. It is possible that the current formation of reality exists as a result of a VK-class reality restructuring scenario. Individuals with living memory of Incident 001 Greek letter Gamma are the last population of humanity able to agree on any shared concept of truth. Their shared experience in seeing or hearing about Incident 001 Greek letter Gamma. The percentage of still living eyewitnesses negatively correlates to the density of unnatural potential energy manifesting in the observable universe as anomalous phenomenon. Their collective memory provides a consistent base of widely, but not universally, held truths. This in turn stabilizes the increasingly individualized SCP-001 perspectives, as it is the last living shared certain truth among Earth's population. Witnesses who do not otherwise provide valued testimony and who have robust physiques may volunteer for experimental and indefinite life-extending experiments, in order to preserve the stabilizing effect their memory provides for as long as the human body can allow. A statistically significant minority of witness testimony report variations on so-called badge man, even taking into account inflation caused by civilians seeing unfamiliar Secret Service and other security forces. The only conclusively proven participants in Incident 001 Greek letter Gamma are John Kennedy and Lee Oswald, although they did not have any prior contact. Other individuals have been named or described often enough to be viewed as persons of interest. On new-fashioned bilateral universality. Collected testimony and evidence for Incident 001 Greek letter Gamma and SCP-001. Written by Truth and Facts Committee. In association with Historical Relevance Committee, Anti-Revisionist Task Force. Preamble. as the increased veiling segmentation of the sheet has produced a confusing number of potential perspectives for personnel to be prepared for. A conclusive report on the development of more branching worldviews and how they may conflict with each other in order to properly prevent bad sight is the accurate and correct way to maintain veil truth. Interpersonal arguments are not considered to be infringing on the sanctity of veil truth at this time as collated through this documentation. S.I. Summary of events and suspects. On the 22nd of November 1963, at 12:30 p.m., Lee Oswald fired two bullets from the sixth floor of the Texas Schoolbook Depository. Oswald's first shot missed, striking a concrete curb. The second shot mortally wounded the president and injured the governor. A third shot, SCP-001, lethally vaporized U.S. President Kennedy's cranial cavity. For the approximate decade between Incident 001 Greek letter Gamma and the ascension of President Gerald Ford, SCP-001's effect was widespread but largely benign. The disparity between perception and reality was growing, but gradually and in a linear fashion. The fractalization did not begin to occur until the failed attempt to assassinate President Ford on the 5th of September, 1975 by Lynn Squeaky Fromm. In both crowds, all witnesses reported seeing differing versions of the events, most of which did not have President Ford surviving. 2 weeks later, Sarah Jane Moore made a subsequent attempt on Ford's life in order to reconcile her knowledge of his death with his visible living person. The exponential spread of SCP-001's effect can be demonstrated by Gerald Ford's sincere belief from at least 1976 until his death that the Soviet Union had withdrawn from Eastern Europe during the Nixon administration. Historical documents reflecting the official story are to suggest that it was the scandal which caused the proliferation of distorted information throughout society, and not the survival of President Ford. Any scenario, whether there exists witness testimony or not, could be true given the ephemeral nature of truth and falsehood on a conceptual level. Suspect and witness testimony. Babushka Lady. Forward. The so-called Babushka Lady was briefly held in custody by the Dallas police, giving a brief statement before she was released. There is no record as to when or why she was released from custody. BL. Yeah, I saw old man Zapruder with that camera, right? Pretty good view from that pillar, especially since the TV crew wasn't there to hog the space. I'm sure a few frames with extra white puffs will just happen to go missing, right? Pause. Lighter flicking. My grandmother loved to play the games she could win. Her favorite was Find the Lady. All you need is a ball, three cups, and a rube to play. There was never a shortage of eager and willing rubes. Grammy relished in showing off every cup as slow as she could, then covering the ball and going to work once she had their trust. Rube watching, she'd shuffle and move em all around fast as tilt-a-whirls. Rube, with luck, picks the right cup. Oh, the sweet talk she'd use to string them along. Come on, double down, let's play one more time, just for the laughs. Poor saps get convinced they've sliced the gambling knot. Everyone was ready to think they were special. We both had a sixth sense for knowing when rubes were getting ready to cash out. By then, they're not even the same person they were when the game started, not after they've been on a hot streak long enough that the money's as good as half spent to them. Zapruder is being played as a shell game. That's the point. If you've seen any home movies, the shaky blurs, the way the timing always seems just a little off, that's by design. The unreality on the surface conceals that if you look at it hard enough, you'll find the fatal flaw. You'll find where the lady is hiding. And never realize, there ain't no lady to find. Umbrella Man. Forward, anonymous tape recording by the alleged Umbrella Man, a person to speak to since he was seen in photographs holding an umbrella beside the motorcade on a sunny day. The Kennedy administration has been a disaster for time and space. Hello. If this take sounds good enough for government work, then it shall be dropping off outside one of your fake used bookstores that really trades in God knows what. There are a million different ways I know you're looking for me, so don't bother looking for a leak. Waste of time. My name is Lowy Stephen Witt and you can come talk to me if you want to. It was my intention to let President Kennedy know of my displeasure towards him. It was a secret symbol, the umbrella, one only he and I would know. Not only would it be disrespectful to the late president, but also his family line. My umbrella can shoot blow darts, yes. But it didn't. I didn't have any of them on me. I only brought this particular umbrella because it is my only black one. Came directly from the Prime Minister. Oh, Neville, you ravishing cad. I've been so lonely since then. The last time I shared any great excitement, I could see the pallor on the faces of passers-by. Truth be told, they probably all saw me the same way. Well, in each of their own little ways they saw me as they saw the world. Skewed, and a little cracked. Fragile, holding together, but, fundamentally, broken. Secretary Reedy. Forward, George Reedy was appointed press secretary by President Johnson after the latter's accession to power. I remember someone once told me Kennedy knew it was a killbox 100% certainty. There were 1,000 ways to die in Dealey Plaza, and Kennedy had made peace with all of them. Why? Back was killing him. The job was killing him. Re-election looked likely. 4 more years of torture and then what? No more hurting and, God willing, heaven bound by the hands of another man. Tragedy should make us come together as one. But now you, and I, and everything, it's split up in little black boxes. I'm not paranoid. The walls have closed in and now we're standing straight up in the dark. I was there when it happened. My first Thanksgiving after, everybody on my mom's side of the family was convinced that I had been convicted of the president's murder. Then, I started to remember it too. I could hear Lyndon's boasting that we would have the greatest administration of all time, and we'd lick the Soviets too. Maybe it did happen that way, I haven't convinced myself enough to be sure. So, I know I squeezed a trigger but I can't remember whose hand it was I was squeezing, if that makes sense. I don't like going out anymore. People all know. Some of them know. Others know other things. But I know that I don't know anything. Nothing true, at least. Jack Ruby. Dallas Police Interview. Jack Ruby. Interview taken inside the Dallas Police Headquarters following Jack Ruby's shooting of Lee Oswald. Ruby, my first thought was, it's over with. Mr. President, you have been avenged. Lighten up a little bit, you pricks. The bad guy got his just desserts. Ruby, you can't be fucking serious. We all know he did it, right? Ah, you know. It was one of you blues that said I would do the world a favor if I capped him. I mean, maybe not thinking I would, but I can't say that he meant anything. Just that he told me to do it. Ruby, I'm gonna be just like Boston Corvette. Yeah, the barn gun guy who did the pop at James Booth. Ruby, you don't need school to know what stuff is. I know one of your guys told me that I was gonna do it. Ruby, he had a yellower, maybe kind of possibly could even be sunflower colored. Ruby, you know me, y'all can't treat me like a stranger. I'm calm. I got it together now. Ruby, I did it, I'm proud of it and I'll do it again if the little shit still has a pulse tomorrow. If my hands can stop shaking. Ruby, so look, between you and me, and the guy. I know the guy who was at the alley door. Well, You know me. You all know me. So I told him I'd get a good look for him. You know what he said to me? Joking. This is what he says to me. He says first drink is on me if you plug him. But he had no idea. I knew, but I had no idea. Ruby, guess he must feel a little shook up now. But I didn't do it because he told me. Ruby, I was coming back from sending one of my girls some cash, didn't even decide if I would do it. Until I did it. Ruby, quit kidding around, you know I always have a piece on me. Just in case. Like tonight. You guys still have the coffee pot going this time of night? Right now I can feel my ticker going a mile a minute, but after I crash I'm going to need a boost to keep myself from dozing off on the way home. Ruby, you're not funny. I'm not gonna keep repeating myself. Saying the same thing over and over again so you screws can yuck it up when you make me trip on my own truth. Ruby, can't believe he did it with Jackie O right next to him. That poor woman. That poor. Poor woman. How did someone that small shoot the president like that? Do you think it's going to rain tomorrow? Ruby, she had that coat, to pull out all the stops for the city. It's the pink one. Someone told me it changed when her husband's brains got all over it. I'm sorry, Mr. President. You see, I didn't want her to have to go through a trial when we all know he did it. There's all this other horse shit they'd try to drag in. My club's a classy spot, so fine. Why, say, do you fellas wanna maybe come tonight once we're done here? Ruby, it's alright. I closed over the weekend but we're still open tomorrow. Ruby, but it was one of you guys who told me to do it, so I'm okay to leave, right? Fidel Castro. Castro, yes, I admit it. I was there. My men were there with me also. We did have guns. Our mission was to show the capitalist's top lapdog how to properly assassinate somebody. The CIA just can't get it done. But that was before I met my Kathleen. Castro. Kathleen Sinclair. We met in a black market, and bonded over a shared love for Cuban cigars and the finer things in life. But she was chained to the Canadian bourgeoisie ruling class through her politician husband. He's the Minister of Fisheries or something very boring like that. Castro, no, we never talked of our homelands. It was just there, in my moment. We made a password that nobody can hear, not ever, but I share it with her and if we ever wish to meet again, say it and our names in a public statement. A signal for everyone with a meaning just for us. Castro, don't laugh. You have all sounded like teenagers again at some point in your lives. I wish I could take her to a baseball game, but safety is not guaranteed outside a safe nest. Castro, I have apologized to my frustrated men, and I apologize to you. Thank you for sending a good submarine to get us even after you knew the mission failed. Cuba thanks you for your services to our revolution. Castro, do you really need to know the word? Okay. Okay. It was Justine. Lee Oswald. Lee Harvey Oswald, interrogation session 7. Attending officers, arresting force. Precinct, Dallas Police Headquarters. Oswald, I'm not squealing or whining. Hey. Hey. I just started living, I just started working here. Just doing my job. Oswald, I don't know how that cop got shot. It doesn't matter. Everyone dies sooner or later. Oswald, really? Even here, in Dallas? I'm surprised, there's really so many people outside ready to rip me limb from limb? Do they know who I am? Are any of them saying anything like, hey, but that was some shot, huh? Oswald, I appreciate good marksmanship. Even if it wasn't me who fired the shot. Oswald, You have no proof. You're framing me. Oswald, it won't go back like that. It hurts. Oswald, I didn't try to do anything for anyone. Oswald, I'm not hungry. Oswald, the cops were already there. I saw badges in the crowd. Oswald, I've never shot at another person even once in my whole life. Oswald, not the general, not the president, not the governor. I don't know. Oswald, I was home. My wife will tell you. She'll tell you. Oswald, I don't know how it got there. I don't know. But I took care of my gun. If that was my piece. If it was my gun, it's you'll know because I took care of it. The gun. My gun. Oswald, I didn't do that to his head. But you know what? I've got nothing to say, not gonna be set up with whatever that was. Oswald, I ran out because, see, I was keeping it cool, but I had looked out the window, and it's just then, when I was looking out the window, I start seeing the whole world shatter like everything outside the window was a movie being projected on glass, and then behind that there was another reel playing, except now the president's head is gone. I didn't want to stick around for the ending. Oswald, God, what an awful mess. What a goddamned awful mess. Secret Service Agent Hickey. Hickey, I've never regretted not regretting anything as much as seeing Kennedy's head. Hickey, he did a weird jerk, and he put his hands up. I thought something was wrong. Too right, too right. The hole was on the bottom of the back of his head. It wasn't bleeding, but it was coming out. I could feel it pulling my eyes in. Hickey, I saw a long, long way in. Hickey, all of this happened over about a second. And. Hickey, I discharged my weapon, right then as whatever I saw was gone, so was he. I'm sorry. Dying Castro. Castro, it wasn't worth it. Castro, what do you want to know about? Second Havana? Castro, I was there. I know how the world works. Nobody knows any place well, not even the places they know best. But this also means that nobody else knows the places well, and there is plenty of space being watched by nobody at all. Castro, everywhere we go is just the idea of that place only we can know. Castro, I tried to share it with Kathleen. But she couldn't see it. Then she couldn't see us. Castro, our daughter made me the father-in-law to one prime minister, and the grandfather to another one. Castro, at some level, my grandson must know. I was never sure enough to call him my grandson, though, so he could never be sure enough of our familiarity. Such is life. Castro, I'll never see any of them, or go there, ever again. Why is it true that we all die alone? S. 2. Individual aggregate level veil effect. The most common effect of SCP-001 is frustration. The belief that one is skilled, but unable to get a job, or that they are wonderful people yet nobody seems to like them. Unable to understand that they are being paid less than they think they are. Feeling cramped and confined even if they see themselves living in a big house all to themselves. Wrongness is there, it can be felt, but it cannot be explained. It manifests in psychological disorders such as imposter syndrome. At a certain level, they know that they don't belong. One more way to feel the lonesomeness of SCP-001. Those with less self-awareness may be promoted via the Dilbert principle, that incompetent individuals will be promoted until they can no longer do damage. This is a natural organizational self-defense measure, as the structure is aware something is wrong, even if none of the participants themselves are able to. The so-called Mandela effect arises when the degree to which any given person is out of sync with reality drifts further in their living memory. So that what was true to them once is no longer so. However, This is easily rationalized and is not considered to be damaging except in rare cases. Analysis of social movements derived from SCP-001 was at first limited to immediate interpretation of the Kennedy assassination, but following disruption of the assassination attempt on Gerald Ford and the subsequent lack of new renewals of blood, the fracturing of collective truth has continued on its path to disintegration. When a critical mass of knowledge an individual is able to interpret as factual have no connection to reality as defined by physical laws and natural forces, it will frequently cause them to disconnect most of their familial and social relationships. This withdrawal is usually a result of frustration and confusion. They may begin to make new social connections in small networks of those who find that their alternative viewpoints overlap on at least some measures. Even in these extreme cases, this does not prevent those with heavily altered viewpoints from carrying out the functions which have become routine. This is more a result of muscle memory, as their will to engage with the wider world is totally broken by their SCP-001 experience. Conclusions. There is no purpose on speculating who killed President Kennedy. Every guess is correct to someone. Nobody can see the world the same way as anyone else. That's just the way it is. Normalcy is a comfort to those confused by SCP-001, and should be provided whenever possible. We secure, contain, and protect. Footnotes. 1. Along with any other resources necessary to maintain a stable lifestyle.